Okay, so we need to address some things. First of all, this is gonna be the first actual like gameplay or whatever that I try out with my full link experience that I wanted in the first place. Because basically in the first like stages of Link journey, I had an anchor cable which was 3 meters long, right? So you saw already in Asgarath, sometimes it was a struggle for me because, and now we're in a different position because in this position I record usually on the quest platform, right? The gameplays. Now we're also in the same positions, but we have installed the pulley systems, we have the official link cable. So today is gonna be the time to test this out, everything. If my vision actually works, because you know, I kind of pursue the link experience pretty much the same as I would play, like you know, room scale-ish, whatever. You know, on Link, because it's kind of like you want to compromise freedom of movement and locomotion for the PC VR experience, and that's kind of like what I was been pursuing that. So we'll see how it goes. I hope nothing will break off. I installed everything pretty much properly and how I want it. The cable is lovely hanging around. I can move like everywhere on my bed. I even thought that the cable would be too short, but it's actually like too long. So I'm surprised by that, and I'm just excited to try it out, right? And after a few days of testing and stuff like that, I will do a proper video overview of that on the cable and the pulley system and everything works, because I pursued the most ideal setup you can get in my apartment. I guess everyone that has an apartment that's a really like low on space area, right? Okay, but today we're gonna test out to Until Fall. I actually wanted to play that before, but Asgarath just took pretty much every my attention. It's basically like a roguelike, sword fighting game, which I like. Like I play Swords of Gargantua, Asgarath, stuff like that. Like I love medieval shit with some like you know gameplay. The main reason I wanted to get the official Oculus cable is that you know that have been having a lot of issues with disconnections and just fucking up my recording, like just nasty stuff. So I do hope that this issue will be resolved through this cable, and we'll see how it goes. But for now, let's see what's about this game. It's actually in early access. It's not like a full-on version, which is interesting because I thought they released the developers the full game. We'll see. And now this game would be pretty fun with room scale, right? Because now I can just like move everywhere. It's really exciting to play PC VR, but with full-on movement. So standing, obviously. Oh, press and hold, okay. We'll see. Okay. New game, I guess. Vignetting? No.
Wake up, champion.
I expect some good action. Oh,
Our
Jesus.
city lies in ruin. In its
Whoa,
place,
okay.
monsters and twisted spirits now thrive. I have restored you as best I can. Together, we can stop this madness. Defend yourself!
Hold both grips to summon your weapons. Wow! Dual wielding! Hell yes! Ah, okay. Ooh! Okay. Align your weapon with the blue block indicator. Okay.
Attack that creature. end this.
Okay.
Well done.
Interesting.
It's time to move.
I can walk, okay.
There's no time to wait.
Do we have like dashing? Ah, okay.
The unraveled will show no mercy. Choose your target.
Ooh, quick turns. Okay. It's kinda smooth locomotion. I mean, yeah, it's fully smooth locomotion. Ah, and dashing is like in this direction. Okay. That's fun.
Eviscerated! Claim the power contained within the blue. Advance, champion!
Grabbing arguments. Restores up to 5 color crystals. Hold triggers to absorb this argument's power.
Keep moving.
What the hell? Ah, it's like a power up. I think. Okay. Posing. Okay, great. Settings, audio, music, lower, just a little bit. Graphics, full everything. Thank you. User interface. Yeah, seems fine. Grab summon toggle, look direction movement. Player always buys on direction the player is looking. Yeah. Comfort. Now. Haptics, camera, walk. Great. Difficulty normal. Okay.
Press on, champion. Strike them down.
That's fun gameplay. Okay. Oh shit. It's very interactive, like combat, which I thought that I will get in the Asgard. It's not bad, it's just. Oh, okay. So I'm choosing the bonuses for the next stage.
Choose wisely.
Adder. Dash damage. Ah, because this is like a roguelike game. Let me lower. You pick up your like power-ups in order to progress, then when you die everything resets like to some extent and then you start over. That's kind of like the premise of the style of the games that is. Dash impact. What does it mean? Increase guard damage dealt by dashing. So used to purchase and upgrade weapons. I don't know if I... Huh. Let's take something safer. I don't know. Because I don't know if these bonuses will like progress to the like whatever.
Why
does strike deal more damage? Oh shit.
They stand no
okay.
chance.
Fuck yes.
Remember, wider swings.
It's kinda like exercise also in combat. Combo limit. Increases total number of critical strikes. Now, I'll take money also. I feel like money will be really good like in the next stages. I don't know. I need yet to die to see and like pass the tutorial how everything exactly works. Dungeon enemies will inflict guard damage. Ah, okay. That's why I was like one hitting everyone. Kinda. Ah, that way, okay. What? Oh, I can dash backwards, great.
Returned to nice. Dust.
So we'll take dash damage then now, because now I know how it works. Okay. I like this style of gameplay. Fuck. I might say it's like the best sword gameplay that I had so far.
Forward.
Hell yes! Lovely. Combo limit. Dash. Okay.
Good. Push forward.
Whoa, is this like a knight? Oh shit. Here. Now I can get more dynamic. Fuck!
This far afield. It's too soon. We're not ready for this.
Oh, we are ready. Fuck you. Holy shit!
Hang on, I've got you.
Hey! Don't cock block me from gameplay. So that was a tutorial basically. Okay. Interesting.
Now you see why I have restored you. Rokar is no more. Should that creature continue unabated, its corruption will unravel reality. When you are ready, return to the surface and destroy that creature. I will arm you with the finest weapons I can muster.
Okay, so this
but
is
only
dummy.
You can combat this horror.
This is like difficulty. Oh hell yes. Easy, normal. Oh yeah. Of course we'll get hard. Sword fighting games are for me like the hardest difficulty I will pick, because this is the games that I excel at, so I want a challenge. This is the weapon station. Uh-huh. What's that? Okay, so oh, this may be like the setups. This I think a shop. I wonder how to summon that. So far only thing I see interactive is the difficulty and this, but I don't know if it's even like no. Okay. So we just picked hard, so we'll see next. How does exactly
each
that work?
So has powerful magic infused into its very essence.
By attacking and blocking.
Through combat, the power contained within each weapon will activate.
Oh, okay. These mystery weapons, with an epic hand, look at your palm and hold trigger to inspect a weapon, and it's super. Engraved arming sword.
And show these creatures your true strength.
Charge time long. Gain 3 temporary armor for the next 20 seconds. Oh, this is full on sword fighting gameplay. Hell yes. Okay. Strike this to consume left your super. Okay, so it's like a stun.
Good.
Okay. So now I have a shield. So attack me. Okay. It's like a good protection. So this will be useful for like bosses or whatever. Okay. I already love this gameplay. Hell yes. So the adder that I was collecting, I actually collected. Yeah, so I don't think this is temporary. Yeah, no. I think, I'm not sure. Is it like... Let me grab one health and we'll see when we'll die. Okay? Maybe actually I'm wrong, which is... Maybe this is how the gameplay is, like... There are temporary... Yeah, permanent bonuses. Nice. You can die. Masterfully done. I can already see that I will blame it a lot more. Okay, so we got health, so next ones. I think block this weapon. No. Gains twice as much supercharge when dealing half damage to enemies. I'll take weapons. I mean, money. Whatever.
The other rune knights have all fallen to the calamity.
Huh.
I fear you may be the last one left. Go, champion. Lay this one to rest.
We'll see. Shit. Oh shit. It's too fast. Wait. Oh damn. Shield. Here. Oh, here. Okay. Fuck. Ah, shit. Okay. So that's how that works. So that's Aether, okay. Oh, there are stages up until the boss fight, maybe. Hold Rigid will rise again. Okay. So the Aether is permanent.
Welcome
what about
back,
health?
Champion.
Health, no.
I have made some
okay.
Progress restoring what is left of my forge.
Interesting.
Equip yourself, champion. My armory is at your disposal.
A new weapon. Empowered strike. This weapon. Okay. Because I don't want, like, I want full offensive stuff. That's what I like. But I like something longer. What? Ah, this is like a glove. Okay, I'll take that. Oh wait, now I have 5 HP. Ah, because it had probably like some bonuses. And I'll take an axe. Yeah? Yeah. Shit. Okay, because there's play bonuses dash impact. I wonder.
To good use.
Okay. So let's see. Huh, I can't use the cloth. Can I like hit or something? Ah, okay. So maybe no. Maybe I'll take a sword. Yeah. Oh, I can, like, I need to summon also. Oh no, because I'm, like, unlocking them. Okay. And like that. So I have an axe and a sword. Oh, there's even, like, a collision. That's attention to detail, bitch. Whoa. Nice. Ah, okay, so I was spending ether on that. Ah, so I spent ether on the weapons. Probably there's gonna be more difficulty. Okay, I'll jump one more time and we'll see. It's kind of like you can't really, if they are not critted, like there's no critical strike, you like need to beware of your surroundings. God damage, max KP, ether. Okay. Okay, yeah, so some are permanent, some are not. So for example, this is risky as fuck. I don't need to restore health, so ether. Okay. I think I'll be fine with dodging backwards and then attacking with guard damage. Yeah, seems like. I'm not a huge fan of blocking mechanics, so. But maybe. Yeah.
Great job.
Shit, I need to focus. Ah, oh, there are dashes. Okay. Okay. Dash impact. Yeah, I'll take that. Shit. And now this guard, and I have 1 HP. Come on. Shit. Aye. Okay. Ah, shit. I suck. I mean, I'm playing on the hard difficulty, but still. That's kind of like the way I want to play. One more. It's a little bit addicting, like I would play that like
good.
Fucking all the time.
Through our efforts, the forge is slowly upgrade, returning to its so. Former glory. With enough aether, I can permanently enhance any weapon of your choice.
Ah. Okay. Can I like check the stats on the actual weapon that I'm grabbing? I mean, I'll take better axe for sure. Additional socket. Huh. Okay. One more.
Done.
Huh. Okay. No, this one. I wonder if it's like better to gather ether for now and then focus on killing the bosses. I've not played a lot of roguelike games, so you know. Okay.
Magnificent.
I need to focus. No. Ah. Okay, no. Ether. No. Yeah, I feel like I'll be taking money all the time. Because that's what kinda is perma meant, right? So we'll see with this big. Oh, fuck. Really fast. Ah, goddammit. Okay, now. Ah, shit. Ah, no, I still suck ass. Okay. Let me return to the base. Ah, Eiko.
Hello, champion.
And that's like the main premise, kinda. You fight, like, constantly try to break the bosses and trying to survive, kinda. Kinda like, so when I, for example, choose that, then I'll upgrade the thing that I'm holding. I know, the one that I have in my hand. Okay, yeah, so I get it. Okay, great. I do wonder how this works, though. I wish I would see. Let me see just real fast. I know, because it's not gonna be... Okay, it is. No? It's not charged? Wait. Okay, there's like no... Okay, whatever, let's say. Save and quit. Oh no, abandon run.
Back so soon, champion?
Okay, so that's pretty much the main premise of the game. Like, roguelike sword fighting, kinda exercise game, which I love. Like, fuck yes. In terms of Link, I mean, it didn't break so far, so I had pretty much smooth gameplay as like the first time, kinda. So I'm excited to try out more. I'll probably do more Asgard record, and then I'll give my final thoughts on the setup. But fuck yes, it's great. And the game actually, because I wanted to try it now because it's actually free till some hour to Sunday this weekend. So it's a pretty good opportunity to see and try it out, you know, but I'll definitely buy it because it's really fun gameplay. Like, I would say it's pretty much the best sword fighting I've played so far. Yeah. But it's like, it's arcadey. It's like, if you are really into like combining weapons and just like, you know, progress, like, it's kind of like a sword fighting Diablo in a way, right? And maybe Diablo is not a good comparison, but like overall this roguelike games, which nothing comes to my mind currently, so whatever. But yeah, I'm gonna play more with Link, and this setup is pretty well. I mean, hell, I can move around everything, Jesus, and like it, nothing tethers me anymore. Ah, that's really fun. Yeah, till next time.